Hey guys, it's Bacardi Breezer for me here, and I would just want to complete my take on the Dracopyre armor series. I've already done my take on the Grace Fang armor, and you know today I decided to go and get the Nightreign. Is that? Yep, I think that's a Nightreign version of the armor. You know, because there has been many comparisons, people are just saying that the Nightreign has more bonus to hit than the, which is accuracy, than the Grace Fang, while Grace Fang triumphs in damage output wise. Alright, so many people, there have been some people who have watched my video on YouTube and had asked me about which armor is better, which was the difference, and yeah, all I have to say is that the difference is minimal, okay? It's so minimal, it really doesn't make a difference. Alright, I'm telling you right now, if I read on the forums that the Grace Fang has more bonus to hit, while the Nightreign has more damage output, I'm telling you, I'll take it as that is true, you know? Even though if it's not, because you seriously can't tell the difference, alright? That's how minimal it is. And yeah, so today I just took out about 20 points off my endurance stat and put it to my luck stat to, you know, I thought that it would give me a slight advantage during the stat rolls. And hey, you know, I took around 12 hours for the Grace Fang with my zero luck stat and rolled perfect hundreds to pass through the stat roll. Took me 12 hours, yeah. I got I reached my caps in, 3 hours? 3 to 4 hours, you saw the bulletin, I reached my caps. And, you know, I just pushed my way through. Didn't care about not getting any rewards. And, you know, my XP and my gold cap was, resetted at 12 PM here in my country, and I got the armor at 12 AM. Alright, I did non-stop playing of the game just to get the Grace Fang armor, and I glad that's true. So with my additional 20 luck stat that I did, I actually got this armor within the hour, you know. I was amazed. I did not know that it will make such a huge difference, alright? But yeah, it did. So that will be one of my advice if you're going for this armor, you know. 20 stat points, come on, that's nothing, right? Just, you know, pump it in, get a slight advantage, save some time, you know. Alright, so with that, I got my Nightreign armor. Alright, I know this is not Nightreign, I think it's Dracopyre of Darkness or something, I'm not too sure, okay? I'm just gonna call it Nightreign, okay? The Crash armor, alright? This armor reminds me of the cartoon character Crash. I'm not sure if any of you know what I'm talking about, but yeah. Holy shit. Alright, never mind. Let's just try it. Oh my god. Okay, never mind. Alright, so we might actually get to see how accurate this armor really is. No? Not bad. Alright. I'm sidetracking here. Alright, so just do a little slight comparison. Alright, first of all, I'll start off with the looks. Well, I'm leaning more towards Grace Fang. It's more kick-ass than the Crash armor here. Oh man. Okay, yeah, I think Grace Fang wins in terms of looks, although they are both still awesome. Okay, I'm gonna die. Alright, I'm just gonna flee here. Okay, defense modifiers. The Grace Fang specializes in earth defense, while the Crash armor triumphs in darkness defense, which is more useful. However, I see armors that you can easily win it in darkness defense wise will be the Shadow Cloak and I'm just gonna say Shadow Cloak and the Darkness Dragon form, which I already have, so I don't really require the, oh man, it's laggy. Alright, I don't really require the Darkness Defense. And yep, but you know, for those who do not have the Darkness Dragon form and the Shadow Cloak, you know, this is a very good alternative. 50k, I say go get it. Alright, plus the Draining Bite. It definitely, I think it wins. I'm not too sure. But I would go with this armor instead of the Shadow Cloak. You know? Yeah, I think that's all I really have to say about this. What else? Oh yeah, and about me, you know, slaying, you know, basically giving this armor a very shit review yesterday. I used the Grease Fang armor the whole of yesterday to reach the entire of my XP cap in the Faring Springs and the layer of Metaphase and Random Adventure. I messed around with the Grease Fang armor, you know. And I've got to say, it's actually quite fun to use, you know. I rarely met a monster which the armor couldn't take down. Yeah, there were some. But, you know, it could handle itself very well. And now I'm, you know, messing around with the Crash armor here. And I've got to say, I'm really starting to enjoy the armor. Although, yeah, so an update about what new stuff about I found out about this armor is that the Grease Fang, if you're fighting a low level mobs, right, low level defenses, and you know, with for Grease Fang with the Draining Bite and everything, the armor abilities, yeah, you know, it definitely wins. I read about it that it's better than the Crash armor here, in terms of pwning low level mobs. And the Crash armor it's better for the higher defense modifiers monsters. Yeah, so just a little extra information. And yeah, I think that I'm done with my take on the comparison of the two armors. And guys, many of you has been, oh my god, am I gonna die again? No, I'm not gonna die again. Yeah, time to noob it up a bit. Okay. Alright guys, those have been asking me about, okay, not only me, okay, other people who have posted a video on the new armor, right? Oh my god, come on people, please read the forums, you know, when a new update comes out, you need information. Please check the forums out, okay? There's many useful information that you can pick up from there. Don't depend on people to post videos and then ask them simple questions, alright? Just do yourself a favor, okay? Do yourself and do us a favor by please reading the forums, alright? For new updates, you can check out the general discussion. For weapon stats, alright? For the new releases, right, for the armor or the weapon or spells, right, you want to go under the AQ Encyclopedia under info submission, alright, and then there's topics with the different categories of new equipment that came out, alright. You want to find out a new armor, you go under info submission, you look under armors, alright, the last page. People would have posted stats by then. You won't be able to find it under the regular weapon subcategory. Right, because I don't think that they would, the staff would actually put it into the encyclopedia that quickly, okay? So yeah, that's all I really have to say. Thank you for watching. Peace.